What is dominating today's headlines is the successful return to Earth, if that's not clear, of a Chinese spacecraft carrying samples from the far side of the moon. Now, state media leading with President Xi Jinping and his message congratulating the mission here, calling it a landmark achievement for China's science and tech ambitions. Now, that story is also among the hottest topics trending on Chinese social media today. In fact, national pride dominating sentiment among Weibo users, with comments saying that the moon mission showcased the strength of the nation, one user posting that it brought tears of pride. Oh, that's touching. There we go. So that's great context, of course, and really the big picture of China's space ambitions is really.
This is the one that had the landing had a. With a bit of graffiti, as they called it, nationalistic graffiti as well. Let's get more on the mission itself and really what it achieved and what it means for China's space ambitions. Our Bruce Einhorn joins us now. Of course, this is supposed to unlock a lot of mysteries that we see in the moon. I mean, what do you think? You know, why was this mission so important?
Well, this is important because it was the first time that anybody had done a sample return mission, meaning going to the moon, picking up rocks, regolith, the surface material of the moon, bringing it back. The first time anyone had done that from the far side of the moon. There have been sample return missions from the near side. Going to the far side is a lot more difficult because it's never in direct contact with the Earth. China's the only country that's ever landed on the far side. They landed the first time in 2019. This latest mission was the second mission from China to the far side, the first time that they actually went, picked up rocks from there, brought it back. Scientists are very excited because the composition of the far side is very different than the near side. You know, when you and I, when we look up at the moon, we can see the sort of the flattish kind of areas. So those areas that they call them seas in English, those don't exist on the far side. And the far side is a lot rockier, a lot more craters. So very different composition. So it's exciting for scientists. Strategically, it's also important because there is a competition between China and the United States to send astronauts to the moon, to establish bases on the moon. There's a theory that there might be reserves of water frozen as ice near the South Pole and also on the far side. So being able to explore those areas could be very important longer term as countries try to establish their presence on the moon longer, permanently.
Yeah, and I think what we just showed our viewers is an animation. There was actually no camera that was shooting the actual landing and takeoff of the aircraft. What comes next then after the successful mission?
So this was Chang'e 6. Yeah. So before this, Chang'e 5 was a sample return mission from the near side. Before that was Chang'e 4, which is the first one to go to the far side. So next is Chang'e 7, which I think is supposed to be in 2026. There are a couple more Chang'e missions. These are all now working toward eventually getting Chinese astronauts to the moon for the first time. The goal is to do that by the end of the decade. And then further out, the Chinese want to build a permanent research station near the South Pole. That's something that China is working with Russia and trying to find some other partners to join up with. That's in opposition to what the United States is doing. The United States has a plan to send astronauts back to the moon for the first time since the Apollo program, which ended in 1972. The United States is working with Japan and a lot of other countries on the Artemis program to send astronauts back there. Japan is supposed to be working, developing the lunar rover that will be part of that program. The U.S. also wants to build a base on the moon. Other countries also are looking to the moon.
Yeah, so wasn't India involved at some point trying to get to the dark side of the moon? I could be remembering, mixing my facts up, but yes.
Yeah, a couple of things on that. So yes, India landed near the South Pole, not on the far side. It was on the near side. And just a little bit of pedantry here. Yeah. We can't call it the dark side. We have to call it the far side because...
But who knows?
Well, no, but we know that the sun is always shining. It does shine over there. We just can't see it.
That
so,
true.
You know, Pink Floyd notwithstanding, it's not
there. You know what's also probably there, and I'm hoping that they get information on this.
What?
You know where your socks go when you wash your socks, and you're always missing some of the.
Oh, maybe that's where they go.
Maybe that's where all the socks go, the lost socks.
Yeah, so maybe that'll be in the payload that just came back yesterday.
Quite a light load.